Hey there, everybody, and welcome back to Sasquatch Speaks. This is Sasquatch, otherwise known as Gavisas, welcoming you all once again to this dark little corner of the internet, which is oh so affectionately referred to as ours. On today's episode, I want to talk a little bit about something. I keep referring to things as trends, and it's really just an observation, a simple observation that in most people, myself included, when something goes wrong and we begin to try and determine why it went wrong, we begin with some sort of a supposition or an assumption that whatever the reason that it is that went wrong, there is one particular reason which cannot simply be the answer. And I'm reminded when I hear people start describing things of, well, this has gone wrong, and oh, it's terrible, it's a tragedy, or, let's take, because it's something that I work with most frequently, let's take finances, for example. Say there's a family who is all of a sudden, you know, finds themselves $100,000 in debt, underwater in their mortgage, just at the very brink of a financial catastrophe. And they suddenly wake up to this and they realize that, holy crap, we're in big trouble and we got to figure out a way out of here. And what caused all this to begin with? And begin to suppose, well, it was this car. It broke down a bunch of times. Or we bought this house where we weren't able to afford it. And it's like, okay, well, those are things that happened. Or, you know, this illness happened. I understand that happens quite often, and it's one of the chief causes of financial ruin in America. In America, I can't speak about overseas because I don't know. But in America, at least, it's one of the most prominent causes of financial ruin, medical issues. But more often than not, and, well, it's a additional problem than the actual problem. And I don't mean to say that in, like, oh, just ignore everyone who's ever been sick or anyone who's ever had a catastrophe or a tragedy in their life. But people begin with the supposition in attempting to find out what happened financially to bring them to some sort of a low point. They always begin with the supposition that, well, it couldn't have been me. It couldn't have been my decisions. It couldn't have been my actions that brought me to this point. So, what else could it have been? And then they begin to lay blame to symptoms rather than cause. And I find it interesting, whenever, I'm just using that as a sort of a jumping off point. There are many other examples. Certain scientific theories and things going around, I'm not going to mention anything particular, and I'm not going to start throwing political or anything else into this because I'm not a scientist and I don't know. But it's interesting how on both sides of an argument, there can be people who can just adamantly declare, first of all, that the cause of whatever it is that we're arguing about cannot clearly be this. Can clearly just not be whatever it is. But we're going to start looking at symptoms, and it's really hard to do this without making specific examples. Okay, I'll do it. I'll get specific. Let's talk about global warming, because that's the one that everyone knows something about. Not generally, we don't know anything about it, but we know just enough to say it's either getting warmer or it's not. One way or the other. Or there's people who just say, well, it's changing. It's like, changing to what? Well, that's a whole other story. Whole other problem. But on both sides, there's this general consensus. On one side, it's like, well, it absolutely cannot be anything to do with mankind and our actions, and it's like, okay, well, maybe, But let's not rule that out from the start. I mean, the other side is like, well, it can't be anything else but mankind. It's clearly all our fault. Well, I wouldn't particularly agree with that either, because it's any sort of extreme statement, anything that specifically excludes or attempts to lay all blame into one area to the exclusion of all others, tends to be a holistically false answer. We try to quantify things we don't understand by avoiding their root cause. Going back to the family situation, or just a person who has brought themselves to the point of financial ruin, or have found themselves at the point of financial ruin, we'll even give them some leeway. And they say, well, I don't have any money. I'm in debt beyond my ability to ever hope to pay it. Okay. Well, how did you get there? Well, this loan and the interest rate, well, did you sign the paperwork? Well, yeah. Did they explain it to you at the office? Well, yeah. Well, you agreed to it. There wasn't anyone holding a gun to your head. You were given some of the terms. And I understand there is such a thing as predatory lending and falsehood in the financial industry. Believe me, I know that. I do my best to rectify that every single day that I am alive. But there does come a point where it's personal accountability. When people just have to accept the fact that some of the things that they have done are wrong and have led them to an unfavorable situation. Now, personally, I used to be an incredibly overweight person. Incredibly. I was almost at the point of being 300 pounds. I understand I'm a pretty big guy anyway, and that's not really the point here. The point is I had allowed myself to get to such a extent of not caring about my personal health that it was dangerous. I was like on the verge of like diabetes and the whole nine yards. It's like, well, I should probably do something about that. Well, what caused this? Well, gee, have I exercised for the last 10 years or so? No, not really. Have I eaten wisely in the last 10 or 12 years or so? No, not really. Well, it's the food's fault. Well, no, there's a point where you can just say, no. It's usually just before that gets to my mouth. It's like, well, it's just that I don't know what to do. Well, there's books, the internet, people passing on the street who are in better shape than you. Just ask them. Oh. Why is it that we always try to preserve our own dignity? And I understand this is probably a very human trait that everyone is born with, and probably is something that just has to be accepted and then overcome personally. But the point still remains that we all do it. We all get to that point very quickly where it's like, I want to preserve my ego, my dignity, my lack of blame, my innocence in the cause of this travesty, of whatever sort of mess or unfavorable situation I found myself, or I've put myself more like as not. You hear stories about drunk drivers and they hit someone and they just, the right life was just ruined and wrecked, and it's like, oh, yeah? But you chose to drink alcohol, first of all. Everyone knows. You know, you can try and give any sort of, well, this part of it's not that bad. Well, it's that part of it, maybe, but all the rest of it, probably not real good for you, and certainly not in copious amounts, where you're knocking back your eighth beer for the night, and you're like, I can't remember where my car is, and you stumble out, and you hit your butt, and all of a sudden it starts beeping at you. Oh, there it is. And you just tumble behind the wheel. And you decide to drive. And you make the decision. Altered state or not, there's a point, even before you started drinking, where you realized, I'm here by myself. And the only way I'm getting home is by me. Or even then, like, hey, maybe there's another way. I can call someone else to come pick me up. But you didn't do that. And rather than trying to take that personal responsibility, you're just like, I can handle it. And as that person begins to drive home, perhaps too fast or just swerving all over the road, it falls out of their control. I don't know why I'm on this depressing topic, this run of just depressing topics. I don't know. Never mind. That's probably a topic for another day. But, this is just a short one. Very short one. I hope someone just figures it out. Just examine yourselves. I'm something I do every single day. Maybe I do it too much. Maybe that's why I'm on this very depressing kick. Maybe I should just restart some sort of a series or something to get it moving in a more positive direction. But when you're looking at your life and you see something you don't like, and you realize, man, this isn't where I wanted it to be. This isn't how I wanted things to go. I thought this was going to be better. I had this planned out so differently. When you get to that point, don't discount your own decisions. Why? Because, quite simply, if you disallow your own thoughts, your own decisions, your own actions from being the causality of the position you are in, the next time those decisions, those very same situations come up, you will be operating under that same false supposition that you can do no wrong. And you'll enter back into a nearly identical situation, just as unfavorable and just as damaging. I don't know why I'm on such a depressing downer series, or not a really. It's not a series. It's just a. I'm just blaming myself and everyone else. There we go. Everyone, just blame yourself. I'm so sorry. That's all I'm going to say today. This is not turning out to be a very positive thing at all. So I'm going to try and come up with something more positive for tomorrow. I might do the gold brick story tomorrow. Let's do the gold brick story tomorrow. Though that could be kind of falling right in line with this, come to think of it. So yeah, we're still going to do the gold brick story tomorrow. I said I was going to do it, and I'm going to do it. All right. So yeah. Thank you all for watching. I hope you have enjoyed. If you did enjoy, like right down below, it'd be very much appreciated. If you didn't enjoy, I understand. This is a very dark, depressing thing to be talking about. People just messing up their lives, and yeah, just I'm sorry. I don't know why I'm on this kick. Anyway, I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.